I'm George Marriner Maull, Artistic Director of the Discovery Orchestra, and your host of NJPAC's Bank of America Classical Overtures. We thought it'd be fun to have some web time with you about this season's Bank of America Classical Series, and as usual, provide some moments of musical discovery, windows for you to find yourself in this music. Have you ever wanted to jump off a cliff? Well, maybe not literally, but perhaps you've done this at a water park, or you've taken the plunge on one of those free-fall rides at an amusement theme park, or maybe you're an experienced skydiver. The essential ingredients of these experiences are, of course, an incredible adrenaline rush owing to the more than a little fright, as well as an intense feeling of satisfaction at the successful conclusion of the event. Instrumental soloists get to do the equivalent of this activity in virtually every concerto they perform. And there's a special moment, often in both the first and third movements of concertos, where this cliff jumping is ritualized. It's the moment of the solo cadenza. On September 22nd, Long Long, the classical music super phenomenon, will perform the Beethoven Piano Concerto No. 3 with the New Jersey Symphony Orchestra under the orchestra's new music director, Jacques Lacombe. In many concertos, everyone in the orchestra, figuratively, runs up to the edge of the cliff with the soloist. They accomplish this by playing a passage of music that ends on a tonic second inversion chord. Now, don't get scared. First, let's deal with the scale. Here is our scale. And again, here is the first pitch of our scale. Here is a three-pitch chord built on the tonic pitch, or the first pitch. A three-pitch chord can be played in three different versions: root position, first inversion, and second inversion. All I've done is switch what's on the bottom. Let me play them again. Here is root position. Here is first inversion. Here is second inversion. The deal is everyone runs up to the edge of the musical cliff, signified by reaching the tonic second inversion chord. Then, without a parachute or a safety net, remember, the soloist is playing from memory, without music. The soloist jumps off by him or herself into what is usually a fantastically, technically challenging solo, designed, in fact, to show off their stuff, to demonstrate to the listener just why this person is considered a virtuoso performer. Let's go right to the moment of the cliff jumping in the first movement of Beethoven's Third Piano Concerto. Did you sense the arrival at the tonic second inversion chord? We've reached the edge of the cliff. Now, often after a tiny sliver of silence, the soloist jumps. You can sense that that solo cadenza is really pulling forth everything that the soloist can muster in the way of technique. But you don't have to go cliff jumping yourself to enjoy the adrenaline rush. You can experience it vicariously with Long Long and the NJSO As a listener, at 7:30 p.m. on Wednesday, September 22nd, in NJPAC's magnificent Prudential Hall. And be sure to check out the NJPAC website for the full program of this exciting concert.